atmosphere where God is connecting the dots and putting all the pieces of the puzzle together. There's a word here today, and it has to do with timing. It has to do with healing. It has to do with power. This is going to sound funny to start with, but since it's me, you're probably accustomed to it. Peyton Manning has had many great years as a quarterback. He's done great things. He's kept his nose clean, if you will, and put up the numbers. And then something unexpected happened to him, and he got sidetracked. It's toward the end of his career, and a young guy steps into his place, and they start winning some games. It looked as though Peyton was going to be benched, and he would end his career on the bench. Then out of nowhere, something unexpected happened right before the playoffs. Right before things started to heat up, right before the opportunity to win one more Super Bowl, something happened, and Mr. Manning got put in the game. Brought his team back to victory. And now today he has the opportunity, as they're playing the first playoff game of this year, he has the opportunity to win the Super Bowl. He thought the opportunity was lost. Now here's why I say all that. I've got this feeling, and it's just been continuing to be confirmed, and Beth was talking about the revelation of the lie. And once you recognize the lie in your life, how sometimes it even seems to get bigger. Because it wants to intimidate you. There is a lie that some of you are believing that it's over. That you had your shot and you've ruined it. That things have happened in your life beyond your control, and now you're benched. And you see that the Super Bowl is about ready to take place. You see that in history, in this timeline of our world history, that things are becoming more intense, and you want to be in the game. You think there's no way it can happen. Let me tell you something. Paul and Silas were just doing ministry. Things were happening in their life. Wonderful things were happening in their life. They were doing great things for the cause of Christ. But then something took place and they got sidetracked. They found themselves locked up in a prison cell. Chained and shackled in a situation that they never expected. Something they didn't see coming. It took them by surprise. They got benched. But while they were on the bench, they had such a desire to get back in the game that in the midst of the darkness, in the midst, as the Bible calls it, the midnight hour, they said, I have to praise Him. I have to praise Him. Yes. identity.
Glory.
When you accept your identity,
yes,
that you have power,
amen,
all of a sudden you begin to pick up things that you couldn't pick up before. And because you're able, yes, to accomplish things you never could accomplish, yes, before, now all of a sudden you can think bigger.
Yes.
You can ask bigger.
Right.
And then because he says he can do that by the power within you, then you could, and then you could think bigger. And then you can think bigger. When you walk in the territory that God has called you to, now this has to be a revelation from God. Only God can do it in you. Only God can do this in you. But when you walk in the territory that you're called to, you cannot be stopped.
Yeah.
I mean, you can't be stopped. You can walk into that place and fear no evil. Because his rod and staff are with you. They will come for you. They will make a way for you. When you're doing what you're called to do, you can't lose. Revelation for this time that we're in, this season that we're in. You can't stop when the time is right. When the time is right. He told David. He told David, there's an army out in front of him. David said, God, what do you want me to do? You want me to go out and fight like I did last time? He said, no. I want you to wait. You wait on the right time. And he said, when you hear the wind blowing through the mulberry trees, then I'll give you some instruction on what to do and how to handle the situation. But you have to wait on the right time. Step out of the boat.
Amen.
Then it's time to step out of the boat. Don't walk on water until he calls you.
Amen.
But when he calls you, this is a great atmosphere to hear the word. So don't want to start.